Morning dear students, in this video I am going to discuss the experimental setup of the experiment named to study the variation of magnetic field due to current carrying circular coil with distance along its axis. So you can see here, this is the apparatus. So in this apparatus we have various components. The first one is battery eliminator. The purpose of this battery eliminator is to convert AC into DC. So if we want to have DC, that is direct current in our circuit, so we can, this eliminator can convert the external supply alternating current into direct current. So this is the battery eliminator having range from 0 to 12 volt. Corresponding we can have current, maximum current, the limit of maximum current is 2 ampere. So we can have current from this battery eliminator in the circuit. So this is the circular coil. Circular coil you can see here, whose magnetic field we want to study. So in this circular coil we have copper coil wrapped along this circle. Here you can, we have the copper coil which you can't see because we have the insulation above the copper coil. Fine. So this is copper coil is wrapped around this circle, and the ends of the copper coil, those are, you can see, those ends are joined here. So when we make these connections, we are allowing this external current to pass through this coil. At these two points, we are making connections, so we are allowing the current to pass through this coil. And we know that whenever the current is passed through the coil, magnetic field is produced. This is the scale. This is scale. It is zero. From here, at the center we have zero. This is the right side of scale. Distance can be changed by 5 cm, 10 cm, 15 cm, 20 cm. And this is the left side of the scale. Here again distance can be varied like 5, 10, 15, 20 and so on. And this, the major component and the important component of this apparatus is called magnetometer box. This is called magnetometer box. This whole apparatus, as I have already discussed with you in theory, that this whole apparatus is called Stewart and Gies tangent galvanometer. Fine, it is Stewart and Gies tangent galvanometer, and this box is called magnetometer box. So let us discuss this magnetometer box. So this is magnetometer box. Here you can see in this magnetometer box, this is circular box, and the whole box is divided into four quadrants, from 0 to 90, from 0 to 90, 0 to 90. This is divided into four quadrants, 0 to 90, 0 to 90. Fine. And we have this black one, this is called magnetic needle. And the purpose of this magnetic needle is to tell the direction of Earth's magnetic field. Fine. And this is silver one, this is pointer. And this pointer will rotate under the effect of magnetic field of circular coil and Earth's magnetic field. And these are kept perpendicular to each other. So this is the scale from where you can note the deflection. This is mirror at the back. The purpose of adding this mirror is to take the reading where the pointer and its image will coincide, just as to remove the parallax error. Fine. This is all about magnetometer box. Now let us discuss how to take the readings with this apparatus. So first of all, before taking the readings, we are to make two adjustments. What are those two adjustments? Since this apparatus is based on tangent law of magnetism, so the basic condition of tangent law of magnetism is that the two magnetic fields, that is magnetic field due to this coil and Earth's magnetic field, both should be perpendicular to each other. So first adjustment which we are to make is that we are to make B and H perpendicular to each other. What is B? B is magnetic field due to this circular coil, and H is magnetic field due to Earth, or we can say due to Earth's magnetism, Earth's magnetic field. So how will how we will get to know the direction of B and H. Since this is circular coil, if the current is flowing in this direction, this is right hand thumb rule. If current is flowing like this or like this, thumb will give you direction of magnetic field. So we can say, since the current is flowing like this, so the magnetic field is along the axis of the coil. So magnetic field will be along this axis. Fine. So magnetic field will be along the axis. This is the direction of magnetic field of circular coil. Next is the direction of magnetic field of earth. So you change this apparatus like this. Fine. This needle is giving you direction of earth's magnetic field. We know that when no current is passing through this apparatus, this needle set in the direction of earth's magnetic field. So this needle is in earth's direction of earth's magnetic field. Since B is in this direction, we want to keep H perpendicular to B. So the needle should be parallel to the plane of this coil. We can say this needle should be perpendicular to the axis of the coil. Fine. So you are to make the setting like this. You can rotate the apparatus like this, such that this needle comes perpendicular to the axis of the coil. So this is first setting in which you have made B and H perpendicular to each other. Now, this is also called that the apparatus is set in magnetic meridian. What is second setting? Second setting is that if no current is passing through this coil, the reading of the pointer should be 0, 0. That means deflection in this apparatus, deflection in this magnetometer box should be 0, 0. Two ends will give you two readings. Two ends of the pointer will give you two readings. So the deflection should be 0, means two ends should be at 0, 0. So for that you can like this, move this. You can move this magnetometer box like this. When you move this magnetometer box, the previous setting is not disturbed. Keep in mind, the previous setting is not being disturbed. So you will move the magnetometer box like this and set two ends of the pointer at 0, 0. So you can see here two ends of the pointers are at 0 and here also it is 0. So these are two initial settings. Afterwards, you are to switch on the current. When you switch on the current, you will note that there will be deflection in the circuit, and due to this deflection, the needle will rotate suddenly. So you can see here, suddenly this needle is giving you deflection. So first of all, I am keeping this magnetometer box at 0. At 0 means, at x equal to 0 means at the center of the circular coil. So at the center of the circular coil, we are keeping the magnetometer box and noting the reading. So first reading you can check from here. Now the deflection in the pointer is, it is 84, and in this side it is also 84. So at x equal to 0, theta is 84. This end you can call as theta 1, and this end of pointer, reading of this end of pointer, you can call as theta 2. You can denote as theta 2. So theta 1 is 84, theta 2 is also 84. Now you are to change the distance. At x equal to 5, we want to take the reading. So here now you will note that the deflection in this magnetometer box, it decreases. Deflection is decreased now. Now both pointers, they are giving the readings as 75 or no, it is 72 and 72. So theta 1 is also 72, theta 2 is also 72. Now further you change the distance at x equal to 10. Now the reading is, let it get stable, and you will after it gets stable, you can note the reading. It is now 52 and 52. Again at x equal to 15, like this, I am moving this magnetometer box. This is the scale. At x equal to 15, this point is at 15. So at x equal to 15, reading is 30, 30. So this is how you can take the readings of right hand side. Now again we also want to plot the graph along left hand side of this circular coil. So for that we move the magnetometer box towards left hand side of the center of the coil, and here x is equal to minus 5 or you can say 5 centimeter towards the left side of circular coil. Again the reading will be same as that of on right hand side. So again you can note the reading, it is 8484. And next at x equal to 10, x equal to 15, x equal to 20. So you will note the readings in this table. This is the table. First of all, this is the amount of current which we are allowing to pass through the coil. This is current, you can note here. And this is the table. This is the serial number. This is distance from the center. X equal to 0 means at the center of the coil. Then you can take the readings at x equal to 5, 10, 15, 20, or you can take the readings at 2, 4, 6, 8. Suppose we are taking the reading at x equal to 5, then 10, then we are taking the reading at 15, or again at 20, so on. This is along left side and this is along right side. So along left side, the first end of pointer will give you reading as theta 11, or you can say as theta 1 dash. And the second end is giving you reading as theta 2 dash. Then you can take the mean of both, that will give you theta dash. And it is, then you will calculate the tangent theta dash. And then you have to plot the graph between x and tangent theta dash. Similarly, along right hand side, the one end of pointer is giving you reading, we are denoting is as theta 1. The second end gives you reading, which we are denoting as theta 2. Then next we have mean theta. Mean theta means theta 1 plus theta 2 divided by 2. Mean theta means mean of these two readings. And from this theta you can calculate tangent theta. And in the end you have to plot graph between x and tangent theta. Along x-axis we have x, that is distance. And along y-axis we'll have tangent theta. Fine? Tangent theta and x. So here x 0, you can keep x as 0, then 5, then 10, 15, 20, corresponding you will note the reading of tangent theta. And from here you can vary the x as minus 5, minus 10, minus 15, minus 20 as that of left hand side, and correspondingly value of tangent theta dash. The shape of the curve will be like this. Fine. So this is the plot between tangent theta and x. Actually we want to plot the variation of b with x. Fine, we want to plot the variation of b with x, but since here tangent law is applicable and according to tangent law b is directly proportional to tangent theta, so variation of b with x will be same as that of variation of tangent theta with x. This is the conclusion which you will write at the end of the experiment. So b with x, variation of b with x will be same as that of tangent theta with x, but the difference will be in magnitude only. If the plot of tangent theta will be like this, the plot of b will be, the magnitude of b will be greater than that of tangent theta, because b is basically h tangent theta, where h is Earth's magnetic field. So this is how you are to take the reading to study the variation of magnetic field due to current carrying circular coil with distance along its axis. Thank you.